Hi, today I will talk about our work, Automated Search-Oriented Toolkit Recovery, on Ciphers with Linear Case Schedule, Applications to Boomerangs in Skinny and Fork Skinny. This is a joint work with Xiaoyang, Xiaoyun Wang, Keting and Yunwen. This talk includes the following four parts. First, motivations and contributions. Differential attack proposed by Behem and Shamir is one of the most successful crypto analysis techniques. In differential attack, an attacker's goal is either to distinguish E from a random function, or to recover the master key based on the differential and partial decryption technique. When searching for differential distinguisher, the attacker aims at differentials that cover the highest number of rounds or with the maximized probability. But for key recovery attack, attacker needs to append several extra rounds EB and EF before and after the differential distinguisher to recover the keys. Using such a good differential distinguisher is more likely to launch a better key recovery attack. However, in practice, a good key recovery attack often requires a comprehensive trade-off between the key recovery phase and the differential distinguisher. In this talk, we try to maximize the number of attacked rounds with data complexity and time complexity lower than the exhaustive search. The constraints that we take into consideration include the probability of the distinguisher, the number of active bits of the input and output, and the number of key bits need to be guessed in the extended rounds. Boomerang attack is a statistical crypto analysis proposed by Wang in 1999. The boomerang distinguisher is constructed by splitting the encryption function into two parts, E0 and E1. Then two short differentials are combined into a longer boomerang. The probability of the boomerang distinguisher is P22, Q22. The boomerang attack is a chosen plan test, chosen cipher test attack. It can be converted into a chosen plan test attack, known as the applied boomerang attack or rectangle attack. In the rectangle attack, considering multiple differentials whose alpha and data are fixed and the internal differences beta and gamma is arbitrary values, the probability of the rectangle attack is 2 minus n, p hat 2, q hat 2. A number of studies have shown advanced techniques for a better evaluation of the boomerang's probability as boomerang switch sandwich attack. In the sandwich attack framework, the ending round cipher ED is splitted into three parts. The middle part EM handles a dependence and contains a small number of rounds. In 2018, previous observations on the boomerang switch are unified in the framework of boomerang connectivity table by Sid et al. Then, several works talked new techniques to consider the middle part consisting of multiple rounds. For block ciphers with linear key schedule, Zhao et al. Proposed a new generalized related key rectangle attack. As a differential attack, we analyze the detailed factors that restrict the rectangle attack framework. Then, we propose a new automatic MILP model for related key rectangle attacks on skinny, where the probability of a distinguisher and the dominating factors of the key recovery phase are systematically processed by the constraints. We are able to find new good properties in the distinguishers, which can be used to perform key recovery attacks, covering more rounds than previous results. Second, automated search oriented to key recovery on Skinny. At Crypto 2016, Baylor et al. Proposed a new lightweight block cipher family, Skinny. It has comparable hardware-software performances with Simon, and also has much stronger security guarantees. Skinny follows an SPN structure and a tech key framework. Let N denote the block size, T denote the tech key size, C denote the cell size. The family of Skinny has six main versions. In each round of Skinny, the state is updated with five operations: subcells, add constants, add round tech key, shift rows, and mix columns. The designers of Skinny first gave the MILP model to search truncated differentials for Skinny. Later, Liu et al. Tweaked the model to search boomerang distinguishers. Recently, Hadipo et al. Introduced a heuristic approach to search boomerang distinguishers using MILP SAT models. They introduced some new tables for S-boxes to model the dependence between the upper and lower differentials, and evaluated the probability of middle part experimentally and mathematically. Almost at the same time, Dillon et al. Proposed a new automatic tool to search boomerang distinguishers and automatically handle the middle rounds. They also provided their source code to facilitate follow-up works. Our new model is mainly based on the last two works. We present an extended model for searching the entire NB plus ND plus NF rounds attack. The aim is to find new distinguishers that result in key recovery attacks with more rounds. Our target is to maximize the total attacked rounds. However, in practical programming, we take NB, ND, and NF as parameters to input the model, and the target is the time complexity. Our new model takes the model of Hadipo et al. And Dillon et al. To search for a NB plus R0 plus RM round upper truncated differential, and a RM plus R1 plus NF round lower truncated differential. The modeling strategies of the distinguisher paths are the same to the previous models. For the active cells, propagation in the EB and EF, the truncated differences are propagated forwards and backwards with probability 1. Hence, the constraints are different from those in the distinguisher. The time complexity of the rectangle attack is highly related to the number of guessed keys in EB. We hope that the smaller MB, the better. Since the matrix in the MC operation is not an MDS matrix, the subtract keys involved in the partial encryption and decryption are different. So we model MB from two aspects. Phase 1, partially encrypt P1 to the active cells in Y3. Phase 2, partially decrypt Y3 bar to get P2. In phase 1 shown in the finger, in order to compute the active cells in Y3, we need to know the cells marked by red dots in X3. Then the cells need to be known in Z2 can be deduced through the linear diffusion. We define a binary variable known in C to identify whether the cell in ZR should be known in phase 1. In phase 2 in the finger, we compute Y3 bar and then deduce delta X3 and delta Y2. Then the calculation from P1 to Y2 is similar to the calculation from P1 to Y3 in phase 1. So in our programming of the model, we integrate the above two phases. We define a binary variable known for each cell in XR to indicate whether the value is needed either in phase 1 or phase 2. For the round NB-1, only active cells need to be known. From round NB-2 to round 0, which cells to be known in ZR can be deduced from XR plus 1 through the linear diffusion as in phase 1. In round NB-2 to round 1, the cells in XR need to be known in wave 2 types. The active cells need to be known in phase 2, and the cells need to be known in ZR. The objective function is the time complexity of the rectangle attack. We add the variables on behalf of different parameters to the objective function. For the probability of the distinguisher, the target is same with Hadipole et al.'s. Besides, we also add known ENC on behalf of the MB, DXL on behalf of the RF to the objective. Because different parameters have different coefficients in the time complexity, we give them different weights to model the objective more accurately. With our new MILP model, we search for more proper truncated upper and lower differentials for K recovery attack. Then use the CP model to get the instantiations for the truncated differentials. We also calculate the probability considering the clustering effect and experimentally calculate the probability of the middle part of the distinguisher. The table gives a summary of related tricky boomerang distinguishers for skinny. Then, related tricky rectangle attacks with new rectangle distinguishers on skinny. We use the 22-round related tricky rectangle distinguisher for Fox skinny 16-4-192. By extending 4 rounds EB and 4 rounds EF, we attack to 30 rounds. In the first round, we first apply SR and MC operations, and then apply the ART operation with the equivalent subtricky ETK0. So there is no subtricky involved in the first round, and we can build our structures at W0 prime. Treating W0 prime as the plan test and Z29 as the cipher test, we get the corresponding attacked parameters. Based on Zhao et al.'s K recovery algorithm, in data collection, we generated Y22-2288 quartets. The K recovery is a guess and filter process. For example, according to the property of the MC operation, we can deduce the difference of X297. Since for the Xbox has two non-zero differences in input and output, there is only one solution on average for the input or output of the Xbox. So we can deduce the STK297 for pairs C1, C3, and C2, C4. The difference in STK297 is fixed and acts as a 4-bit filter, so the number of remaining quartets is reduced. This table gives the time complexity and guessed or deduced subtrackies of each step in the tricky recovery process. Set the expanded number of right quartets as equal 1 and the advantage h equal 36. We construct 220.87 structures. The data complexity is the chosen plain text under the four related trackies. The memory complexity includes the memory to store the plaintext, ciphertext sets, and the key counters. The time complexity includes the time of generating quartets in data collection and the time of recovering keys. The success probability is 59.5%. For observations of N2N and N3N of Skinny, we also give input attacks using the new rectangle distinguishers. There are several Krypton analysis results on Skinny under single Twankey and related Twankey settings using different techniques. We summarize the Krypton analytic results on Skinny in related Twankey setting for three versions. Our results cover one more round than the best previous attacks. Last, the related Twankey rectangle attacks on Fox Skinny. Fox Skinny is designed under the Fox AE lightweight authenticated encryption framework. The primitive is based on Skinny, as shown in the figure. After the first R init round Skinny, the encryption procedure is forked. Two copies of the output are separately processed by R1 and R2 round Skinny. The Twankey keys are generated by the Twankey key schedule of Skinny for R init plus R1 plus R2 rounds in total. There are several instances with variant block sizes and Twankey key sizes. Previous analysis of Skinny can directly be applied to Fox Skinny. But as pointed out by Barrett et al., encryption from M to C1 use a slightly different Twankey key schedule, lead to better analysis. When R0 is added, the unround keys before and after the forking point are taken from the same half of the master Twankey key. So if data STK R init minus 1 equals 0, we can deduce data STK init plus R0 equal to 0. Especially when R0 equal to 27, when use a data whose period of the LFSR is 15, if data STK R init minus 2 equal to 0 and there is no difference in STK R init minus 1, one can have 6 consecutive inactive round Twankey keys. We add constraints of those properties to the model of Skinny to search new distinguishers. For Fox Skinny 128-256, we select a 21-round related Twankey key rectangle distinguisher. As in the figure, there are 6 consecutive inactive round Twankey keys in the 14-round to 19-round. By adding 3 rounds before and 4 rounds after the 21-round distinguisher, we give a 28-round key recovery attack on Fox Skinny 128-256 with 256 bit key. The attack procedure is similar to the attacks on Skinny. Using the same distinguisher, we add 1 round before and 3 rounds after the distinguisher to achieve a 25-round attack with 128-bit K and 128-bit tweak. We summarize the attacks on Fox Skinny in related Twankey key setting. Our results cover 1 to 2 more rounds than the best previous works. That's everything I want to talk about. Thanks for your attention.